Hello fashion lovers and welcome to Fashion Den Stylista Moda. If you find this video interesting, please like the video. If you find this channel informative, please subscribe the channel and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you will get all the notifications once it has been uploaded. So in today's video, we are going to learn the pageant top that is for 18 years. Pageant top that is for 18 years. The measurement that we require for this is all round chest 36 inches, all cross back is 14 inches, that means the width of the shoulder, top length, and that means the length of the garment is 25 inches. This may be increased as per your taste. We are making it up till a bit down from the hip level, 2 to 3 inches down from the hip level. So if you want to increase it, you can increase it as per your requirement and taste. So let's start the process. For that, first we have to draw a line, that is a fold line AB. Let's make it with the blue color. This is a fold line, that is A, and this is B. A to B is equal to 25 inches, that means the length, the top length. That means the length we require for the garment. From this point, we have to draw a parallel line from this line AB, that is, let's say it's line CD, this to this, this is line C, this is line D. AB is equal to CD, but of course, and parallel distance is 2 inches. Or you can say AB is parallel to CD by 2 inches. This will provide the fullness to the garment. In pageant that you have seen, the in the center, in the middle, there are the gatherings. So to consume the gatherings, we are taking this 2 inches. You can increase this as per the taste or as you want the fullness of the garment. So here I am marking a point D. Here I am marking a point D as C to D is equal to 7 inches, that means half of the crossback. Crossback is 14, for half is 7 inches. Here I am marking a point E on line CD as C to E is equal to 8 inches, that means 1/4 of the all round bust, all round chest minus 1 inch. That means 36 divided by 4 is 9 inches, minus 1 inch, that is 8 inch. And we'll square out a line from point E and mark a point F as EF is equal to 9.5 inch, that means 1/4 of the all round bust plus 1/2 inch for the ease. That you may avoid, ease may be avoided in this garment, but it is always recommended to give ease because it will give ease to this portion, the portion from for of the armhole. From point D, we'll draw a perpendicular and mark a point G. That means D is perpendicular on EF to mark G. Right? This. Now we'll draw from D we'll square out a line. That means it should be of 90 degree H, where DH is equal to EF. EF is equal to DH, and we'll just have to join these both lines, right? Now we'll give shape to the neckline. For that, I'll mark a point C dash from point C as C to C dash is equal to 2.75 inches. That is the neck width. And C to C double dash is equal to 4 inches. That is the depth of the neck. In this case, we do keep the depth of neck little we don't want it to be deep because we want to create the gathers in this, and it will not look good if you will create it in more depth. Otherwise, the generally that neck depth starts from 6 inches, but here we are taking 4 inches because this is a pigeon style of top. And now we'll give shape to this, and we will join C to F. We will also join C to F. This. Fine. Now we'll give shape it to the garment. First, we'll give shape to the neckline with the help of French curve. Either you can give this shape or with your expert hands, as what you like. This is the shape of the neck, right? From point G, we have to mark a point I as GI is equal to 1/2 inches. This is the point I. This is point I, where G to I is equal to 1/2 inch. Now we'll give shape to the front armhole. See how we'll do this. The point where neckline is intersecting on the line CF, this to the point I, this to the point F. With a smooth curve, you have to do this like this. This will be the armhole, right? Because it has an armhole just like in raglan sleeve, so we will be creating it like this only, right? And now we have to give shape to the back armhole. So again, we'll mark a point J as G to J. This is the point J. I'll say this is the point J, this point, as G to J is equal to 1 inch. And we will just draw the armhole as we have done in case of front. This is the armhole of back, the green one you can see, and the blue one is the armhole of front. And this will be the shape of the entire bodies. This two. We have to join this, and this also. This is the shape of bodies. Now let's consider the sleeve. Bodies is clear now. Now let's consider the sleeve. For sleeve, what we'll do, we'll mark a fold line, that is again AB. This that is A, that is B, this is on hold, this is on hold, and this is the grain, right? This is on fold. So A to B here is equal to 13 inches. Why 13 inches? Half of the shoulder, yani half of the cross back plus sleeve length. Here we are taking the sleeve length of six inches. So 7 plus 6 is equal to 13 inches. Now this is the fold line. Parallel to the fold line, 2 inches parallel to the fold line, we have to take a line CD. We have to take a line CD. This CD is equal to AB. In the same way, CD is parallel to AB by 2 inches, right? Now we have to take a point E and F as CE is equal to DF is equal to 7 inches, that means half of the cross back. This portion is half of the cross back. Like this and like this. Fine. Now again we have to draw the shape of neckline here. Same will do. C dash with the same measurement as we have done here. C dash is equal to 2.75 inches. C double dash is equal to 4 inches and we'll draw a neckline from here to there, right? Now see what we'll do. We have to mark a point G as EG is equal to 9.5 inches, that means 1/4 of all round chest plus half inch, equivalent to this line, this point will be equivalent to this, and we have to join this to this. Right. Now what we'll do, we'll mark two points H here and I here as H here, I here and J. H is taken at the intersection. First we have to take this line, let's say this is H and H dash, as C to H is equal to E to H dash is equal to 7 inches, that means half of the CB, right? And we have to join this line too. Like this. On the intersection of this line, I'll mark a point I, on the intersection of this point, I'll mark a point I, and half inch above is J, and again half inch above is K. Just like we have done here, G half inch to give the shape to the front and back armhole. And now we'll give the shape to the front and back armhole. It will be opposite to the top, the front armhole here is deeper, while the front armhole will be, this will be the front armhole, the outer one, 1 inch, and this, right, with a smooth curve we can match this, and this will be the back armhole, 1/2 inch wala will be back armhole, like this, right. Now we'll give shape to the sleeve. We'll mark a point L as here. FL is equal to 1 inch, and we'll just join this to this. I'll take a point L dash, as L to L dash is equal to 1/2 inch, and provide the shape to the lower curve of arm and extend to this, and I'll extend it to this. This will be the sleeve, and this is the grain of the sleeve. Got this? This is the fold, this is the grain. Now we'll make a band which we want to put here, just to give the shape to the pigeon in proper way. It would be an block of ABCD. On fold line, A, B, C, D, A to B 1 inch, C, D, and A to C is equal to, A to C is equal to 6 inches, that means 1/2 of the sleeve bottom. So this is, and this will be the grain line, right? So this is the pigeon top. Here you can see the sleeve portion will attach here. It will complete the neckline. It will provide it to the fullness. It will provide it to the fullness. That means 2 inch fullness here. That means 4 inch altogether fullness you can give to the front neck, and 4 inch here to the sleeve. 4 inch here, and if you want to give, you can give a smoking impact to the waist. But if you don't want to, you may even leave this. It's a very beautiful top to wear, and this will be the shape of the top. If you will see the basic design ideas, like here it will be done with the gathers, if you want to give impact here, you can give the impact to the gathers. If you don't want, you can even leave this normal. So this will be the shape of pigeon top, right? So in next lesson we'll learn some other types of tops. Till then, bye bye, and see you again.